Okay. Good evening, Onanda. We are going to we are welcoming you for the Mental Health Webinar Series 2020 and 2021 on behalf of American College Madurai, Red Pond Educational Institute and Yellow Pond Counseling Center Madurai and MS Chellamuthi Institute Madras School of Social Work and TNCC and TNCP and STEPS Foundation. Welcome, Onanda. Today the resource person is Dr. Suresh Kumar Murugesan. Is going to talk about the how to overcome laziness, the needed topic of the hour. So all we are know about the Dr. Suresh Kumar Murugesan, but for the couple of people, I would like to introduce. He is the passionate researcher, professor, and mental health practitioner. Right now, he is the head of the department of PG department of psychology, American College, and he is the founder of. He is the founder of Yellow Pond and Red Pond Counseling Center, and he is the founder of TNCC and the co-founder of TNCPA. On this note, I would like to welcome Dr. Suresh Kumar Murugesan. Over to you, sir.
So thank you, sir, for that wonderful welcome for me. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Audible. Yeah.
This is the topic we can find out. Most of the motivation speakers and the people who are in the field of training, they focus on this one: how to overcome laziness. Laziness and procrastination, these were the many terms they are using. And when we search the answer for the question, we can find out very limited answer for this. And they will explain that what is laziness, what are the causes, and what are the facts about it. In every detail we can get it. But when it comes to that strategy, even for me, it is like a layman perspective. There are very limited research supporting strategies are available, and I found that I'm going to share with you. There are three strategies, and the five strategy in which three of them are having the evidences, and remaining two are not having the evidences. But when you Google it, when you search that, you can find out as much as techniques, as much as technique to work on the laziness, but. I'm going to tell you the research supported three techniques. Along with that, there are two more techniques I'm going to tell you. We will begin from what is laziness. When we have an idea to do something and when we fail to do that, we are having many reasons for that. Laziness is the quality of being unwilling to work. Or we are having the energy, but we don't want to lose the energy. That we can call that laziness. Okay. Yes. Generally, we can say that idleness. You know, that is a common meaning for the term laziness. When we search in the Google, we can get it. Unwilling to work, unwilling to use the energy what we are having. So that is called laziness. And laziness is we can find out that even the people who are uncomfortable and they feel difficult being laziness. Some people, it is very difficult to become lazy. And some people, they feel more comfortable coming out from the laziness. It feels far uncomfortable for some other people. I'll give some of the examples for the laziness. For example, as I said, the student will procrastinate in school. For example, if the teacher give an assignment or a test, if they cannot able to complete the test, so what they will do? They will wait for the last minute to submit that assignment or work assigned by the teacher. Last minute, I think including me, many of us here. One of the study is saying that for academic related procrastination is very, very high, especially the adolescence age. Those who complicate school education, when they're getting into the college level, and their procrastination level is very, very high. And I'm going to tell you the statistics for that and also. And if you are a professional, when the work is assigned to us, it is challenging and it takes more energy, more hard work for the particular work, and definitely we'll do the procrastination in the professional side. And when it comes to that athlete, so when they will be lazy and procrastinate, you know, when they found injury and they felt that something is very important game and they feel that they cannot able to compete, and that time they can procrastinate. So it is on fact, and these are some of the examples we can understand that. There are many causes are there for procrastination. So some of the common procrastination causes are lack of motivation, a lack of self-confidence, not setting an effective goal for that activity, fear of failure, fear of accountability and responsibility, negative self-talk, distraction, depression. We are not able to make the decisions and poor lifestyle. So these were the causes of laziness. And there are one more point here. And they quickly lose the energy. They feel more tired and they feel overwhelming. They are afraid of doing the particular work. And if they were hurt by somebody else, uninspired, the work may not be inspiring. They may not show any interest at all. They start it in between. So these are some of the causes for the laziness. I'm going to add you some of the facts related to laziness. One of the studies on, they found that is estimated that non-participation rate in workforce, which is close to 40%, you take any given organization. And actually, work is assigned to all, but only 60% of the people they will do, and the remaining 40% of the people they will not do at all. And they won't do any kind of work. So, for example, these research findings known to many of the companies, they are saying that legitimately, they are giving the reason to that supervisors that, see, only 60% of the people are working and 40% not working. You can make them to work, and then I will work. This kind of comment, we can get it from the employees, those who are aware about the research study. And a few more studies about that. 98% of people generally we procrastinate at least once in our lifetime. Okay. 26% admit that. Seriously. And 26% they admitted that they are chronic in nature. For example, most of the time they want to be there in the bed. And 40% of people have suffered financial loss. And because they are not involved in that any kind of activity or work, and if they work only, they can earn the money. Because of this laziness, they cannot be able to get financial activity. And 20% of people do procrastinate, and they found that they have the high chances of losing the job, losing the health, and poor in their relationship, and they may have the financial problem also. So these things were found from the different studies. And as I said, regarding the student, especially college students, school students are not at all, most of the time they are not lazy, but it is an interesting study found that 80 to 95% college students, they are procrastinate on a regular basis. Okay, we'll see. So the lethargy concept we can find out. And one study which was conducted in 2007, they found that they procrastinate regular basis. Even for preparation of the examination or preparing the assignment, and they put it up, okay, we'll do it the last minute, we'll do that last minute. And for that laziness and procrastination, what is the cause for that? The technology, what they are holding in the hand, especially for devices and Facebook. So these were the common thing we can find that responsible for the procrastination. When we look at the animals, so there are two animals which are lazy in nature, only and polar. Interesting fact is that in a day, 20 hours they are in the sleep. That means 80% of their life they are in that, they are spending for sleep. And there is one more, the slowest, laziest animal. When you Google it, you can find out the sloth. Like a polar, it also very slow, 20 hours of sleeping, but the movement and the saving the energy is very high. And they given the reason for that because they are eating eucalyptus and it has a more fibrous one. It takes a lot of time to digest. That needs more energy. So they are preserving it. But the laziest animal, these are the two animals, and some of the human beings also, they are competing with these two animals, polar and sloth. And you may encounter one or two persons in your lifetime also. Okay. And the reason for laziness. Earlier we have discussed about some of the reasons. I'm going to add some of the few more reasons for our laziness here. One is on when we will be lazy. One, sometimes we feel more, we are not having the adequate skills for that. Skill set, if you are not having, okay, we'll see last minute. Someone will wait for someone to come and help us. And lack of interest and involvement in that any kind of activities. And lack of motivation, maybe from internal or maybe the external, they are the cause for that laziness. And fear of failure. Many of the people who are working, they have that. Fear of failure is an important cause for laziness. Okay, if I fail, we have to try that. So that also makes an important reason for that. And resilience and repulsion. Resistance and repulsion. Where we can find out, okay, and there is an inner voice, we may hear that. I think we had a few sessions with Dr. Vidya Hari and Swamla ma'am. They've given some of the strategies, how we can say that positive word, how we can change the positive word that make us change in our behavior. Here, there is an inner voice that we can't do that. We cannot do that. That kind of word, they may hear more frequently. And there are other reasons I'm going to add you here for understanding, for laziness, for personal problem. Okay, and they may have a goal, which may be our goal or target they may set in the beginning, which may not be reachable. They struggle with some part of that the work they have taken up, and they feel that if it is too easy, or the people generally they will lazy. Okay, I know I can never do that. Even a single minute in an hour, I can do that. That means that also make them people are lazy, and the people are not valued by the management or by the teacher. Definitely they will be lazy. Okay, if I do that, I'm not going to get any credit. Why I have to do that? If there is a lack of difficulty in the work. So for example, I have a problem in doing the particular work and I have the difficulty. And first time I may try, second time I think, have the second time, okay, this will be difficult and another one will get easy. I will have to go for that one. And too much, when we have the more time, and that also reason for the, okay, we are having 8 hours, but for doing the work is only 1 hour. Okay, so that, also important reason for our laziness and not enough self-esteem and self-efficacy. Self-esteem and self-efficacy is the thing when we feel that, okay, yes, I can do that. Some of the people, they are having the low self-esteem and low self-efficacy. I can't do that. This kind of thoughts are there. Definitely the person goes to that, highly prone to the laziness. And not no sufficient moral support. If there is no one supporting their initiative, no one supporting from externally, they may not do that. And doing that same kind of work, monotonous work, same tone of work, and the regularity of work, at one point of time, they may lose that interest. And fear of rejection became very common among the people, and lack of interest, procrastination, and you can see that if they don't know what to do, sometimes they may, in the work environment, they will say that, okay, I'm here, I don't know what to do, that's why I'm lazy. If you ask them why you are not doing anything, I don't know what to do, that's why I'm here. When we were in front of the computer, people are stuck, sometimes we may be very lazy. The attitude, the attitude is an important reason for it. Generally, the nature of the person will be lazy. So these were some of the reasons I hear. Then we will discuss about the ways to overcome the laziness. So the first three of them are having more research supporting strategy, and the last three is not a research supported, but only one study I found for the last two. So what is the first strategy you can adapt on it? And do a 5 to 10 minutes daily review or set a effective goals. Okay, that is a more effective one. And this one is proven a technique, a strategy we can adapt to overcome the laziness. And this one has as I said, adequate number of studies which were carried out. Okay. What we can do that when you set a goal, okay. So when you introspect yourself, sometimes you may know there are many methods, other one of the methods is an introspection. When you introspect yourself, it's not much than 5 minutes. You can just introspect in a day, okay, how you spend the particular day. So you can prioritize what needs to be done in the beginning. And the goal which you have set, you just look into that, okay, these are the priority wise you can do that and give important to the most. Sometimes what we will do, we may give not important thing in the beginning. And you can check these are the questions in your mind while you are reviewing your activity. what appointments and meetings require me to be somewhere at a set time. So for example, in a given time, where I have to be there, what work I have to do there. Are there any emergency emails or any emergency work that need to be immediately addressed? Okay, what specific task which related to the patches or blocks of time I have scheduled for a day can I complete? And these were the questions you can ask. What are the 80-20 tasks? And you can set a smart goal and you can start from the hardest. Okay, when you complete the hardest one in the beginning, okay, that will have the quickly, okay, the energy will get up, okay, you can do the other thing very easily. And as I said, there are a number of reviews are there. I'm not given the name, but I'll give you that article related to that saying that goal setting or reviewing the daily task, okay, that has a huge impact on overcoming laziness, because they will aware about that, okay, we are lazy person. Many people, they may not aware about they are lazy. It is because they are not reviewing that particular day. For example, in a day, 8 hours. In 8 hours, when you check today itself or yesterday or day before yesterday, you can look into that. How many hours you were not actively or productively involved yourself in different activities? When you check that, you can able to understand. Very clearly, we can understand that, okay, out of 8 hours, we spend quality work for our progress only 1 hour or 2 hours. And the second supporting strategy you can adopt is that focus on our MIT. What is most important task? MIT is nothing but most important task. So some people, they feel that it's very hard to overcome the laziness. In the day, if they begin a day, there are number of tasks they are having, number of appointments, number of work they are having in a day. And it may be, just imagine that you are having 10 to 15 works in a day. And we are not able to complete the work, then it is very difficult. So most important task we can find out, then we can move on to the next one. We can simply identify that the task we have in our mind. Like in the beginning, what we have done, we analyze that, what are the important things. Here we can identify that which one is very important, the biggest impact that we make in our career, biggest impact that we make in our life, biggest impact that we make in our relationship. So when we know that, okay, these things we must give priority immediately, and other things we may not again. And when we do these things, and then we will get clarity about it. So second one is most important topic. When we were reviewing, we may listed out that there are different activities. Okay, these activities are very important. We can do that. And another strategy you can use to counter your laziness is that in-house matrix. So here it is a 4x4 matrix, and you will get to know that. Actually, who is he? During that World War II. He was in the army, then he has to make an n number of decisions. So he prepared this one. Some of the decisions he need to make very urgent, some of the decisions he can make it very, very important. Some of the things are, when you look at them in the office, you can find there are two kind of files you can find. One is red color tag and one is green color. Urgent, not urgent. So the concept is arrived from the for making the quick decisions. And these strategies will help us to make to better decision to overcome the laziness. Okay, how we can prefer this one? One is you can take a white papers, okay, 7 white papers, you can fold it. You can take 7 white papers and fold it in a 4 way. And one is you can write in the right, just look at here, important, not important, and you can see urgent and not urgent. And 2, plan, delegate and eliminate. So these are priority. For example, there are 4 tasks are in between, and one of the tasks here in the 2, and you have to take it from here, not from here, the eliminate one. Some people, they spend most of the thing at 4 and 3, and which may not be not important at all, and not urgent at all. They will focus on these things, and finally they may not have any time for these things. So those people are, we can say, the laziest person. Even most of the parents were complaining about the children. Okay, he is doing many things, but he is not doing what we are expecting. That's why they are labeling as a lazy person. So you can take 7 paper and put like that. And each day you can just make it. Once you have accomplished your things, and then you can make it the 4 quarter you have to prepare. And you can do 1, 2, 3, and 4. You can do the priority. After 1, you can go to the 2nd and 4, 3, and then 4. Okay. So this is a way we have to focus on that. And this method will be very effective method to fight that racism. And associate with high energetic people. As we all know that when we were close with more positive and more energetic and more alcoholic person, and we also tend to get that energy, and we were motivated to work along with the members. Very. So when someone is working, and when you found that, okay, that person is working, and when you look at that one point of, okay, we were lazy, we have to do that. So that kind of thought we can develop. So when you feel lazy, you find out and look at the person somewhere who are more effective, more active in that work. And final strategy I can give you here, and some of the motivational talks. You can listen to the talk or you can read the things. And when you do these things, you can counter the laziness. So how the listening and reading will help us to overcome the laziness? When we listen motivational talks, it not only help us to overcome the laziness, it internally motivates that, okay, we human beings are on here to do something for other members. We are here for make meaningful imprint in that society. When we realize that, when we listen such a words from that renowned saint, then that will motivate us to talk, come out from the laziness. Okay. And when we read more books, we believe that, okay, for example, sometimes you feel more low energy, and that time you can take a book and then read. And when you count the quadrant, as I said earlier, when you are prioritizing, okay, out of 4 hours, I read 3 hours of books. So that energy involved, okay, you can motivate yourself. So you can engage yourself to counter the laziness. As I said, there are a number of strategies out there. And as per my review, and I found that these are the 5 which have some extent of research findings. So I included here, and you can take any one of the techniques. One is you can take a to-do list for 5 to 10 minutes, daily review, goal setting, and focus on the most important thing in a day. And the Eisenhower matrix, 4 into 4 matrix. And finally, you can go to that, associate with highly energetic people, and listen and read good things. So these are the points. Some of the references for today's presentations are here. Thank you so much for listening. And if you have any questions, please let me know. I try to answer your questions. Thank you. So over to you, Salim sir. Salim sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah. Sir, thank you very much. It was a very wonderful session. And needed our also. The topic of laziness, and you very well explained. Now it is a question and session. Participant, you can unmute yourself and you can ask the question, or you can put in the chat box, we can able to read it.
Hey members, if you come across any of the important strategy, you felt that help us to overcome the laziness, you can always welcome. You can also chat with him.
Suresh, good evening.
Yeah.
Sir, good evening.
Good evening.
Sir, I wanted to ask you a small thing many times in conditions like depression or anxiety, one doesn't feel like doing the anything. Whether it should be called laziness or it should not be called laziness.
Yeah, that also costs for our laziness, but yes, we have to call it laziness, sir. So, yes, we have to make it, we have to call that.
Okay, sir. Thank you. But sir, there is one thing is there, like in such situations where the person is already having negative thoughts and like he is having a depression, and if he is not like he is not doing anything, and when the people call him lazy or they bully him or grill him, so don't you think that their condition may worsen, or they will feel more bad about it?
Yes, sir. I too agree with you the point here. When you look at that, many of the members who are lazy, they may not aware about that they are not lazy at all. Am I right, sir?
Right.
Yeah. So how we make them to aware about their lazy persons? One is the people who are around them. They have to say that okay, in a day, we can check yourself, and in a single day, you can check yourself. And if you do at least 50 plus percentage of time, if you spend for your productivity, it's maybe for your work or maybe for academic. That means you are not a lazy person. But at the same time, when the person is not spending, then we can they will realize it. Am I right?
Okay, sir.
So the best way to counter laziness is the members and the people who are working to counter the laziness. We have to make them to aware about the laziness. Okay. So when I get that yes, I am a lazy person, then they will come out. They will move forward to overcome the laziness.
Okay. Okay. So this means awareness has to be brought into that person so that corrective steps can be taken.
Yes, that person himself has to understand that they have to realize that yes, I'm a lazy person.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Welcome.
Hello, Dr. Suresh.
Yes, Abhijit. Yes.
Yeah, so you know, I will not you know leave a session without a question. So as usual, I have a question.
Okay.
So for homeschooling kids, Dr. Suresh, for homeschooling kids in the age gap of you know like little teen, 12 to 16, you know around that age gap, lot of academics, you know, homeschooling kids also plan their studies. And effectively achieve their objectives. So they adopt a strategy. I'd like to share it with you all.
Yes, 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 yes.
So they adopt a strategy. It's like it's a simple strategy. We already saw a few of them here. Like the Eisenhower thing, they do that. And another thing is they just list out their objectives, the long term objectives. Okay, and according to that long term objectives, they narrow down, in simple words, they narrow down their objectives and strike with an appropriate activity that helps them to achieve their long term goal, long term passion, or whatever you say. Homeschooling kids, they are really good in doing this thing. So I just want to highlight that for anyone is associated with homeschoolers, you know, kindly look into them and you can find wonderful things. They plan wonders. They are kids and they plan wonderfully. You can learn a lot from them. That's what I wanted to share.
Thank you. Thank you for that. I too agree with you. And when we make and understand the person in homeschooling, the person who know that rules and regulations in when they go for a school and they get external force, when they see other members, there's an observation learning ladder. Learn from other members. Thank you for the input.
True.
Salim, sir.
Yes, sir. I think there is no other question, sir. Hmm? Hello.
Sir, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, I had a question, sir. Laziness be like, I have known a few people like in the same family, like 2-3 people are having the same habit of unable to be wake up in the morning or having a proper sleep pattern or being like lazy, unable to do their task, not doing their daily task. Could it be like something genetic or is it like just a learned behavior which is to be corrected, sir?
See, it's a both, I think. So it is a lifestyle as well as genetics also caused by that. I can say that both. Genetic also may be the reason for that, and lifestyle changes. Even many of them were using the gadgets. So most of the time we were with the gadgets. So when the time taken for going to the bed itself, it is delayed. So that's why the pattern of getting up from the bed also very late. These things we can find it only this generation, but when you look at the previous generation, and they will be there in the 5:30 early, they can get up from the bed and then they will do the activities. When in front of them, we are lazy, most laziest persons. That is the reality. And when we do ourselves to a chart, okay, if I'm not a lazy, what are the benefits? If I'm a lazy, what are the things I'm going to do? We ask the person to compare these things, and definitely they will go to the bed earlier and then they wake up earlier. This is my input for your personality, I think.
Sir, I have I know a person, I told them to try, like, at least list out while sleeping, try these things. But he is not able to, like, overcome the factor. He is still having the same thing. Like, I told, like, they both are cousins. It both have the same thing. So how could, what would you say if we had to help them? How could we help them getting better?
I can give my own example here. I think many of my friends who are aware about that, I think I never seen sunrise in my life, at least 2 decades. At least 2 decades. I think most of the time I'm not regularly going to wake up at early morning. But one point of time, I realized I enjoyed the fruit of waking up in the early morning. Okay. So when I was enrolled myself for the yoga, and I get up in the morning earlier at 5:30, 5:45, when I see the sunrise for frequently for 10 to 10, 15 days, I make a huge changes in my behavior. So that thing they may understand at one point of time. Only thing is, when we give the input from externally to the person, they may not take that information. We have to make the person to realize by themselves. So that means the strategy we adapted is not appropriate for the person, and we have to change the strategy to person to understand that. Okay, if we change, what kind of benefit we will get? They have to understand internally, then only it will work.
So that means one should enroll himself into an expensive program like yoga or gym or something like that. So if he cannot afford to be lazy, so he wakes up early and he is compelled to go there. Is it like that, sir?
Yeah, I agree. For example, there are free programs are there, and another program is a paid one. Which one will be more on time? It is a free program. Okay, we'll go there. It's free only. But when you pay the money, we will value the money, what we paid for the particular program. So we will be there before that program. So money also plays, and there are many factors are playing on that.
So ma'am, you ask them, suggest them to book in a slot in the early morning expensive program, most expensive program in gym or yoga. So that will make them wake up early.
Sir, try that also, sir. Still didn't work.
So only what can help them?
when I'm searching answer for this question, how to overcome that laziness, I found out that there are many articles out there, and most of them were not research-based evidences. That's why I said one of the articles is 21 strategies to overcome laziness, but there are no research findings supporting that particular strategy. But I found these strategies are helping the people to overcome the laziness. Why don't we try? I can say that when we say that these things to other members, we have to try ourselves. And when we felt that, okay, these strategies are effective to overcome the laziness within us, definitely we can suggest these strategies to other members. We can try ourselves. So as I said, my
example.
Yes,
sir, can behavior modification techniques work in this situation, like reward and punishment?
Yeah, definitely behavior techniques will be more effective for the children and not for adolescents. So
not for adolescents.
Yeah, not effective for adolescents. So they raise some, like, they are having more number of questions. Why not? For adolescents, having why not? Because most of the years they were followed by the rules and regulations of the parents. They tried to break that. Okay. So that's why behavior techniques, when you look at the behavior therapy, is highly effective among the children rather than adolescents and adult. But cognitive therapy is more effective for adults. But emotional techniques, I'll let you tell you here, how we can make a change in that behavior of the person. We have to go for emotion. REPT may help the people overcome the problem for adolescents, especially for adolescents. because that is a period we can find out stress and storm. There are many hormonal imbalances will be there. So they may not have that clarity in the decision. So emotionally, when we are connected, then we can be able to make a change. But behavior techniques will be more effective. For example, systematic sensitization, systematic desensitization, these things will be highly effective among the children. This is my personal understanding and thing. I'll say that.
Sir, how about an adolescent's motivation? One solid big motivation is there, then don't you think that he would wake up early and
definitely, for example, look at, sir, I'll tell you, there are many of your circulars, you know that the adolescent stage, they may not take proper health hygiene. If the person fall in love with another person, everything will be changed. All the clean habits we can find within a person. So there are motivation definitely will make the person to come out from the laziness.
I was referring to that only, sir.
Yeah, okay. Yes. Sometimes that external force also help to break that laziness, but I can say that when it comes to external or internal, I can say internal has more powerful than external components.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for answering all the questions, sir. So a lot of positive feedback, sir. So it was a very nice session and we learned a lot, sir. Shall we go for the vote of thanks, sir? I think
yes, answer all the questions.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
On behalf of participant and all the organizers, I would like to thank you and kindly accept our gratitude, sir. And on behalf of American College Madurai and MS Chellamuthu Institute Madurai, Red Pond Educational Institute, Research Center Madurai and Yellow Pond Counseling Center Madurai and Madras School of Social Work Chennai and TNCC and TNCPA and STEPS Foundation. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you all the participants. We will have yet another wonderful session tomorrow evening at the same time. Until then, bye bye. Thank you, Anandar. You can find the certificate link in the chat box.